As expected, the All Blacks team named today to face Japan in Tokyo on Saturday is one of the most inexperienced New Zealand teams in recent memory, with 22 of the 23 players who featured in last weekend's win over Australia already departed to the UK for the team's three upcoming games there. The New Zealand squad to face Japan includes 8 uncapped players. It also includes 10 players with less than 10 caps, while 54 test hooker Dane Coles, playing his first test in more than a year, is one of just a handful of players who could be considered familiar faces. Sports reporter Clay Wilson joins me in the studio now. This team, pretty green looking. Is it what you expected though?
Oh, it is what we expected, because this test was put on the calendar really as a promotional tool for next year's World Cup, which is of course is in Japan. Of the 51 players named, there was always going to be a lot of them going to head early to the UK. So we're always going to see a pretty green team for this. So we've got 8 debutants, and 2 of those are starting now. They are really notable because you look at the likes of Dalton Papali'i, a flanker. He's still only 21 years old, so he's been a real standout for Auckland and the Blues, and Auckland, of course, won this year's NPC competition. The other is Matt Proctor. He's a midfielder from Wellington. He's a bit older. He's 26, which you could probably consider as quite old to make your debut for the All Blacks nowadays. He's from, Wellington, the Hurricanes, a midfielder, but a player who's been really, really solid. So, then 6 other players on the bench who are set to make their debuts. 3 players from the Canterbury team who lost to Auckland in the final. But some players who have done some pretty good things this year and got noticed by the selectors.
So with all the freshies then, who are the familiar players who will be relied on to lead the way?
Yeah, well, Luke Whitelock is going to captain the team from number 8. But really, Dane Coles, as you mentioned in your intro there, he's easily the most experienced player with 54 test caps. There's only 4 others with more than 10 caps. You have your 2 wingers in Nehemel Niskata and Waisaki Naholo, and then 2 players in the forwards, Offa Tuanga Fasi and Patrick Tuipulotu. There's also a few players who have been around the environment for a while, the likes of Geordie Barrett, Nat Lamapi, as I mentioned, Richie Mwanga, and a couple of front rowers, Tim Perry and Liam Coltman. So there is some experience there, but on the whole, pretty inexperienced side.
Yeah, so given that on the whole it is an inexperienced side, can any of these players push a case for being in starting lineup against England next weekend?
Well, Coles is the one that really stands out here. I mean, he has been out for more than a year, but before he left, he really was one of the best players in the world in any position. He was just doing really good things, and All Blacks fans will well remember what he was capable of. Cody Taylor, though, who's taken that number 2 jersey, has really made that jersey his own. He's really grown and grown as a player. So perhaps it would be a push for Coles to take that number 2 spot for the England game. But a really good game might get Steve Hansen and co thinking. The others are the outside backs, Naholo, Geordie Barrett and Milner Scudder. They're players who are probably only one spot outside of being in that starting 23. So likewise with Dane Coles, a great performance, it might get the selectors thinking a little bit.
Let's switch codes. White Ferns cricketers departing tonight for Women's World T20 in the West Indies. You were at the event for them leaving. How are they feeling?
Yeah, I guess as you expect before a tournament like this, very positive, very excited. It's a team with a point to prove. So you can tell they're eager to get on the road and get going. They've got a couple of warm-up games early next week, and then they start against India. So one of the other title contenders at this tournament. That's next Saturday morning, New Zealand time.
So are they capable of winning the tournament?
Well, the short answer is yes. They are coming off a 3-0 series loss to Australia just recently. But I guess that's been motivating for them. They're also adapting to a bit of a change in leadership. The captaincy has changed with Susie Bates stepping down, long-time captain, and Amy Satterthwaite coming in and taking that role. So there is some adaptation going on, but it's a team with world-class players, the likes of Bates, Satterthwaite, Sophie Devine, and then young Amelia Kerr, who a lot of cricket fans will know, 18 years old, and just probably one of the best young women's cricketers in the world at the moment. So, I think motivation obviously won't also be a factor given the series loss to Australia and the last couple of world tournaments, World T20 2016 and last year's One Day World Cup. The White Ferns went away with a lot of expectation and didn't necessarily reach that. So the couple of players I spoke to today definitely said that was a motivating factor. They wanted to prove that they were capable of winning on the biggest stage.
So they'll be putting pressure on themselves. Thanks, Clay. Certainly. Appreciate it.